गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग योर फर्स्ट लेसन। वी हैड फिनिश्ड एक्सरसाइज 1.1 इन द लास्ट क्लास। टुडे विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, इरेशनल नंबर्स एंड रियल नंबर्स। टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट इरेशनल नंबर्स, हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट इरेशनल नंबर्स ऑन द नंबर लाइन, व्हाट आर रियल नंबर्स, दिस एंड ऑल विल बी लर्निंग इन दिस लेसन। सो today's topic, what is the topic name? The topic name is irrational numbers. Okay, this is the topic name, irrational numbers. Okay, now what are irrational numbers? First, let us see what is rational numbers. In last class, I had explained what are rational numbers, what are natural numbers. Now, please go through your notes and see what is rational numbers. The numbers that can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers. Where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. The definition of rational numbers are numbers that can be represented in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. This is the definition for rational numbers. What is irrational number? As the word itself suggests, ir means opposite. Opposite to the rational numbers. What will be the definition for irrational numbers? Irrational number definition will be the number which cannot be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. That will be the definition of irrational numbers. Example of irrational number is root 2, root 3, root 5 and pi. But see, root 4 is not an irrational number, because root 4, what it will become? Root 4 will become 2. So 2 is what? Rational number. 2 can be written as 1 by 2, that is P by Q form. Correct, no? So root 4 is not a irrational number. Root 2, root 3, root 5, pi, you know what is the value of pi? No, 22/7, that is also irrational. These are some example of irrational numbers. Now what is real number? Let us see real numbers. Real number is denoted by capital letter R. Okay, see, irrational numbers plus rational numbers. See, rational numbers together, these two are called as real numbers. Okay, all irrational numbers and all rational numbers together are called real numbers. That you should keep in mind. So I can tell all irrational numbers are real numbers, all rational numbers are real numbers, but all rational numbers are not irrational numbers, all real numbers are not rational numbers, all real numbers are not irrational numbers, but all irrational numbers are real numbers, all rational numbers are real numbers. Arthagthide thane nodi, irrational number and rational numbers together ottige real number na form madutte. Adike ella real irrational numbers real numbers, ella rational numbers no real numbers, adre ella real numbers irrational numbers agala, ella irrational numbers rational numbers, sorry, ella रियल नंबर्स रैशनल नंबर्स आगल एल्ला रियल नंबर्स इर्राशनल नंबर्स आगल एरडु सेरिद्रे मात्र इर्राशनल नंबर रैशनल नंबर टुगेदर आर कॉल्ड एज रियल नंबर्स दैट यू शुड कीप इन माइंड ओके दिस एंड ऑल नो नीड ऑफ राइटिंग ओके दिस इज जस्ट फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग so this much you have understood now I have told you this is root 2 root 3 root 5 all of these are what root 5 all of these are irrational numbers see in a number line we can easily represent integers and real numbers no see 1 2 3 if I say represent 1 I will show here this is the place of 1 2 means here similarly 3 4 5 everything I can represent even minus 1 I can represent everything I can represent now how can I represent this root 2 on the number line that we will see in the example 3 okay example 3 okay see in example 3 what they are asking they are asking to locate root 2 on the number line okay locate root 2 on the number line they are asking see example 3 locate root 2 on the number line how should I locate root 2 solution of example they don't need of writing in your class works it is in your textbook you can see from your textbook but this example 3 is very important for your exam okay see root 2 was discovered by greeks okay root 2 was discovered by greek how to represent root 2 we will represent root 2 using the help of a unit square now what is a square you know what is the square no square means it is a geometrical shape whose all sides are equal that is oa side will be equal to ab side will be equal to bc side will be equal to co side all the four sides will be equal now what is unit square means all the sides will be 1 cm then it will be called as unit square not only 1 cm it can be 1 meter also 1 kilometer also 1 means unit but for representing on the number line we will take as 1 cm okay because 1 meter and all we cannot write in book okay so we are taking as 1 cm now if I draw a diagonal here from to connect point O this is O and B if I draw a diagonal we can see one triangle is forming here what is the triangle which is forming here is OAB triangle see one more thing the angle between OA and OB sorry OA and AB this side and this side will be always 90 degree in square this angle will also be 90 degree this angle will also be 90 degree this angle all the internal angles will be 90 degree in a square so see from figure let us consider triangle OAB OAB triangle OAB is a right angled right angle triangle okay OAB is a right angle triangle see I had explained about Pythagoras theorem, no? Pythagoras theorem I have already explained you. What is the definition, what is the statement of the Pythagoras theorem? That is, see this side, only triangle I am considering, no? Forget about this and all. In triangle OAB, listen carefully, this is very important. In triangle OAB is a right angle triangle. So angle 90 degrees here, the opposite side to 90 degree, that is side OB, this will be the hypotenuse side. Side OA, this side is there, no? See here, see here carefully, this side is what? This side is what? This is the base, this side will be the perpendicular side. So according from Pythagoras theorem, what we can write? I told, no, about, I would explained about Pythagoras theorem in the last class. What is the Pythagoras theorem? Hypotenuse square will be equal to sum of the squares of other two sides, that is OA square plus AB square. Say in this triangle, this is a right angle triangle, so the hypotenuse side will be equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. This is from the what? This is from the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, now you know what is this now? OA is 1 centimeter, so 1 square plus, you know what is AB, no? AB side is also 1 centimeter. You don't know what is OB, so how to find OB? OB will be square root of, if square goes that side, it will become square root of 1 square plus 1 square. Now OB will be equal to square, 1 square is 1, again 1 square is 1, 1 plus 1 will be 2, so 2 root 2 will be your OB. So I can write here OB is root 2. Now we have found root 2. This root 2 I should represent on number line. How can I represent? I should place this unit square on the number line, then I should take a compass and cut an arc from, I should keep the compass tip at O point, and from B if I cut an arc onto the number line, I will get the root 2 representation on the number line. Okay, so how to do it? See, I will zoom in, please watch this carefully. Okay. Take a scale. Okay. Draw a number line using a pencil. See here, I will be using pen only so that it should be visible for you. So I'm drawing a number line. Okay, I'll draw a number line. Now I should mark the what? Points, correct, no? After each 1 centimeter point you should mark. Okay, between one point to another point, 1 centimeter distance should be there. One point in the inner point madhya, 1 centimeter distance irbek. Athara point na, on 6 points na mark madi. Okay na? This let us take as 0. I'll take this as 1. This as 2. This as 3. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. so on. This side also it will go on. Now, how to represent this unit square on this number line? See, from 0 to 1 it is 1 centimeter. 0 to 1 it is 1 centimeter. Okay. 0 to 1 it is 1 centimeter. So at the 0 point I will mark it as O. At the point 1 I will mark it as A. So our base is finished. So I should write what? Perpendicular. Perpendicular line I should write. How can I write? Using a protractor. See, the center point is there now here. It should coincide with the A point. And the line here, see, the line is there now. This line should be on the number line. Then only we will get 90 degree. I placed it as at what? A point. And see, the protractor line and number line are coinciding. I will mark 90 degree. 90 degree is here. I am marking the 90 degree. Okay, 90 degree. Now this is finished. I marked the 90 degree. But how much centimeter line I need? I need 1 centimeter line. So you should take a scale. Take a scale. See, this point and this point should be straight. Like that you should keep the scale and draw 1 centimeter line. Between 5 and 6, here see, 5 and 6 is there. Between 5 and 6, how much centimeter is there? 1 centimeter. So, I am writing 1 centimeter. Okay. This point will be what? Let us mark it as B. Okay. Now, join B point and O point. Join B point and O point. Now, this is how much centimeter? 1 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter. This angle is how much? 90 degree. We have marked, correct? No, 90 degree I took, no. So, this and all marking you should do carefully, okay? So, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, base is 1 centimeter, perpendicular is 1 centimeter. This is a 90 degree. So this is a right angle triangle. So what will be the hypotenuse? We have found the hypotenuse, no? 2, root 2. So this is the root 2 line. So now you have got what? You have got root 2. How can I mark it on the number line? Take the compass, place this tip of the compass on point O, then take the distance of OB, that is pencil should be on B, okay? This B, pencil should be on B. One second. Pencil should be on B, then cut an arc onto the line. See, in pencil it is visible, no? I'll overlap it with pencil. This is the arc from using the compass, I have cut an arc from B to number line by keeping the tip of the point, tip of the compass on the O point. I have cut an arc. So this point where this arc and number line will meet, I'll mark it as P. Okay, P will represent. See, P will represent P will represent root 2. Okay, so where is the root 2 on the number line? If there is, it is at the point P. Point P is representing the root 2 on the number line. Understood? Okay, this is very important. How did I do? First, I considered a unit square. I drew one diagonal between O and P. Then I consider the right angle triangle OAB. Using Pythagoras theorem, I found out the hypotenuse, that was root 2. Then I represented it on the number line. Okay. Now, how to represent root 3 on the number line? Let us see. This is your example. See. Coming to example 4, see, in your test book it is example 4. Locate root 3 on the number line. How to locate root 3 on the number line? Let us see. See, root 3 how to represent root 3 on the number line? Let us see. For representing root 3 on the number line, what I should first I should construct a root 2 on the number line. Then I should take root 2 as the base and 1 centimeter as the perpendicular line, and then I should find out the hypotenuse side. Then what I should do? I should cut an arc. Okay, let us see how to do. See, how to find out root 2? Let us take one. This and all don't write, okay? In exam also you should not write. Only what is important, this is just for your understanding. This is a right angle triangle. See, if this base, let us take it as O, as this point is O, this let us take it as B, and this let us take it as what? A. This is, it should be root 3, means what this 2 should be, no? This should be root 2 and this should be 1. Okay? Then only this hypotenuse will be what? Root 3. How I am telling, no? Root 3 I can write it as root 2 plus root 1. So root 2 plus root 1 is 1 only. So root 3 I can write it as root 2 plus root 1. So if this is a hypotenuse, the base should be root 2. This should be taken as the base of the triangle, and this should be taken as the perpendicular of the triangle. But root 2, how can I measure? Using scale I cannot measure root 2. So what I am doing, no? So this is the real solution. From here you should solve. This is all for your understanding. When they ask represent root 3 on the number line, you should start like this. Take a scale, draw a straight line. After drawing straight line, I told you, six points you mark, so that between each point, each corresponding point, there should be 1 centimeter gap. Okay, around 6 to 7 points you can mark. So I have marked the points. Okay, understanding, no? ಅರ್ಥಾಗ್ತಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ. ಇವೆರಡು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಮಧ್ಯೆ 1 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್, ಇದ್ರ ಮಧ್ಯನೂ 1 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್, ಇದ್ರ ಮಧ್ಯನೂ 1 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್. ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ 1 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಈಚ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್, ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಐ ಎಮ್ ಮಾರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ 0, 1, 2 and 3. ಇಯರ್ -1, -2, -3, ಸೊ ಆನ್. ಇಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೊ ಆನ್. ನೌ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ರೂಟ್ 3. ಬಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ರೂಟ್ 3, I should find out root 2 first. Root 2, how to find? You know, no? I should take this as similar to the last sum. This 0 and For finding out root 2, base should be 1 and perpendicular should be 1. So, 0 point I am taking as O. At point 1 I am taking as A. So, this is 1 centimeter. Then what, using protractor, I'll mark 90 degree and draw 1 centimeter line. This last similar to the last sum. All these steps are similar to the last sum. See, 1 centimeter, 1 second, 1 centimeter line I have drawn. Then I should mark this point as B, then join B and O. B and O, so this will become root 2. This is 1 centimeter, this is root 2 centimeter. Okay, no, this is 1 and this is 1, this is root 2. Now, I found out root 2, but there are, in the question they are asking to find out root 3, correct? No. So, how to make root 3? Base should be root 2. So, we have got the base, but I did not get the perpendicular side. So, I should mark the perpendicular. How should I mark? See, this tip should be on the B point. And this line should be on the OB line. This line, see, like this you should place. Okay. Okay, you have placed. Now what you should do, you should mark the 90 degree. You have marked the 90 degree. Then, using the help of the scale, should draw 1 centimeter line. See how to draw. Carefully you should watch. Okay. See, that 90 degree point I have marked now. And this B point should be in straight line. Then I will draw what? One line I am drawing. Okay. Line I am drawing. So then this point will be, let us mark it as what? Let us mark it as D. Okay, this point let us mark it as D. So, from D to O, one line let us draw. So, from D to O, I am drawing one line. This will be your root 3. This line, the distance from O to D, the length of this line will be root 3. Now, root 3 you have found. How to represent it on the number line? Using the compass. Take a compass, tip of the compass, place it as the at the origin, that is O point. Then pencil, you take it to the D point, not B. Don't get confused. B is here. If I wanted to mark root 2, I should cut from B. But I want to mark root 3, so I should cut from D. The arc should be from D. From D onto the number line, I should put one arc. Arc. See, this arc is there, no? This point, I will mark it as some Q. Okay. If you want, you can mark root 2 also. How to mark root 2? On the number line, I am taking at O point, the compass, then at point B, I am taking the pencil and cut an arc onto the number line. See, I will mark this point as P. Where? So, P will represent what? P will represent root 2 and Q will represent root 3. So, I will write here point Q. Represents root 3. I am writing here. Okay. If it is not visible, see, I will draw again using the overlap, using the pen. See, like this it will come. Okay. Understood how to represent this on the number line? Understanding, students? Everything? Okay. That's all. All your example sums are finished. So, open your notes, please. Please open your notes. So you opened the notes, no? Copy down the notes, continue the notes. Last time exercise 1.2 we had finished. From here you should write the notes. See notes, I will not give so too much time. If I am fast, you pause the video, copy the notes and then play the video. Okay. Irrational numbers. Irrational numbers. IRRATIONALNUMBERS. Irrational numbers. Irrational numbers, semicolon. Definition of irrational number, we copy. Irrational number, semicolon. The number that cannot be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. I'll repeat. Irrational numbers. The numbers that cannot be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. Write the definition. Example also you write. Root 2, root 3, pi, etc. Next is real numbers. Copy down real numbers. Real numbers. The collection of rational numbers and irrational numbers together are called real numbers, denoted by R. I'll repeat. Real numbers. The collection of rational numbers and irrational numbers together are called real numbers, denoted by R. See, Pythagoras theorem statement and diagram I have given. In the next page, the formula is also there. So please copy down this Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem. Statement of Pythagoras theorem is also given here. Copy down. Pythagoras theorem. Copy. PYTHAGORAS. Pythagoras theorem. THEOREM theorem. Pythagoras theorem. Semicolon. In right angle triangle, the square of hypotenuse 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 side is equal to the sum of square of other two sides. That what is the meaning, you know. I'll repeat. In a right angle triangle, square of hypotenuse side is equal to the sum of square of other two sides. Okay, copy down this diagram. Hypotenuse side is OA, base is OB. Okay, perpendicular side is AB. Okay, if you have finished, then come to next page and copy down this formula. OA square, that is hypotenuse square, will be equal to sum of other two sides, square of sum of square of other two sides. Other two sides is OB and AB. Their squares, if we add, we'll get the square of the hypotenuse. Only hypotenuse if I need means the square will go to the other side and become root. Okay, copy down this fast. Copied. Okay, I hope you're copying. See, if you can't copy, pause the video, copy and then play the video. Exercise 1.2. Statement, state whether the following are true or false. Justify your answer. Some statements they are given in the first main. We should say whether the statement is true or false. Every irrational number is a real number. True or false? I had explained this now. While in this class only I have explained. True, yes. Since the collection of real number is made up of rational and irrational numbers, we can say that every irrational number is a real number. Okay. Second statement, you see, every point on the number line is of the form root m, where m is a natural number. See, what is the meaning? No, if all the points on the number line is somewhat root m, it is somewhat a in it is in the form of root m. Andre number line meliro yella points root m formal idya, where m is a natural number. Natural number andre gottalva, 1 2 3 4 5 etc, that is natural number starting from 1 to 5. ಓಕೆ ನಾ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಪಾಯಿಂಟು ರೂಟ್ ಎಂ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತಾ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಫಾಲ್ಸ್, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದು ರೂಟ್ ಎಂ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆನಾ, ಓಕೆನಾ. ಸೊ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್, ನೋ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ವಯರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಪೀಟ್ solutions. False, you should write the reason, justification you should write as no negative number can be the square root of any natural number. Okay, the last statement of the first question is every real number is a irrational number. See, I'm telling again and again, every irrational number is rational number. Sorry, every irrational number is real number, but every real number is not irrational number. Why? For example, 3 is a rational number, so 3 will be real number also, but 3 is not irrational number. So, okay, but 3 is not a irrational number. So you should write the statement as false. Justification is 3 is a real number but not irrational number. Okay, finished copying this. Let us go to the second question of your exercise 1.2. Are the square root of all positive integer irrational? If not, give an example of the square root of a number that is rational. See, this also I had explained during this class starting only. I have explained. See, root 4 will be equal to what? 2. Okay, root 16 will be equal to 4. This and 2 and 4 are rational numbers, so they cannot be taken as irrational numbers. So root 4 is equal to 2, so root 4 will be rational number. Root 16 will be equal to what? 4. So root 16 is also rational number. So all the square roots of positive integers are not irrational numbers. So I can write false. For example, root 4 is equal to 2 is a rational number. This you should write as the statement. Okay, I hope you have copied this. Last one in this exercise is what? Last question in this exercise, that is your third question, is locate root 5 on the number line. This is your last question, that is the third question of your exercise. See, again I should use the what example of use Pythagoras theorem I should take help of a right angle triangle and solve this. There are two methods to solve this. How? First method is you should find out root 2 using the example sum. We had found out root 2, no? Like that, root 2 I should find, then I should find root 3, then I should find root 4, then I should find root 5. Then I should put an arc from root 5 to the number line. That is one method. Second and easy method is take a right angle triangle. Okay, right angle triangle I am taking. Base is 2 cm, perpendicular is 1 cm, then the hypotenuse will be, if the base is 2 cm, perpendicular is 1 cm, hypotenuse will be root 5, okay? If it is, this is O, A, B, so A, B square is equal to OA square plus OB square. So AB will be equal to what is root of OB square plus, sorry, OA square plus OB square. So you know what is OA, no? OA is 2 square plus, you know what is this, no? OB, that is 1 square. So if I take 2 as the base, and 1 as the perpendicular, what I'll get? 2 square is how much? 4 plus 1 square is 1. AB will be equal to root 5. So this is correct, no? So I should represent root 5 on the number line, means I should represent this triangle on the number line. How to represent? You know, it is very easy. Take a scale, draw a number line with the help of the scale, mark some 6 points with 1 cm distance between them. Okay. So let us take this as 0, this as 1, this as 2, this as 3, this as minus 1 and minus 2. So what should be the base? Base should be 2 centimeters. So what I should do? This is 1 centimeter, this is 1 centimeter. So total it will be 2 cm. So at 0 point I will mark as O. At point 2 is there, no? 2 is representing, no? There I will mark A. Okay. Near 2 I am marking A, and near 0 I am marking. So this distance will be 2 cm. Okay, 2 cm this distance will be. Now, what should be the perpendicular line? Perpendicular line should be 1 cm. So, how can I? 1 cm perpendicular line. Perpendicular line means 90 degree. How to draw? You know, no 90 degree line. Take the compass, mark the 90 degree. Sorry, take the protractor. Mark the 90 degree, then take scale, make sure the point which you have marked and the A point is in a straight line. Then with the help of the scale, you can draw one straight line of 1 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter line. Then if you join this point, I'm taking this point as B. I should join B and O. Okay, and after joining B and O, I'll get root 5. Then how to mark it on the number line? Take a compass, tip of the compass on the O point. Then from B to number line, I should cut one arc. See, I have cut an arc from B to thing. This I am writing using pen because it should be usable for you. Should write in pencil only. Don't get confused. This point is A. That is 2 is A. This new point which is found by the intersection of arc and the number line, that let us mark it as P only. Okay. Then what you will write? P is equal to root 5. Okay, and this you should write, and this number line you should write. This also you should explain. This diagram also you should write. From this only you are able to write this number line. Okay. For this is it for today's class. We have finished exercise 1.1 and 1.2. In the next class, we will be finishing the remaining things. Okay. So next topic will be your what? Decimal expansion of real numbers. Okay, that is also an interesting topic. Okay, students, thank you.